The impeachment saga of the suspended Chief Justice Cholinder Shamsher Rana might just hit a snag as it happens to be the last day of the five-year term of the House. With significant dilly-dallying that includes authenticating a 174-page clarification recorded by Rana, the scenario is likely that the lower house is all set to expire tonight without a final say in the impeachment case. The stand taken by the members of the committee with a leaning towards the main opposition has also not helped the cause. Good morning, I'm Sarah Sapsanama, and these are the headlines of the hour. The 5 years term of federal parliament remained dismal due to internal and external party bickerings, the session of the parliament coming to an end from midnight tonight. The search for Tukucha watercourse is now on thanks to Kathmandu Metropolis campaign of heritage conservation. Many more structures likely to be dismantled in the coming days. Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky accuses Russia of committing war crimes in Ukraine's northeast, as outcome of the war hinges on the swift delivery of foreign weapons to Ukraine. And Aston Villa post a scrappy home victory over Southampton as the Premier League resumes. Fulham scored 3 goals in 6 minutes to pick up their 3rd victory of the season. The term of the House of Representatives is ending midnight tonight. In the 5 years of its tenure, the public had hoped for the parliament to work towards ending political instability, forming laws in line with the constitution, and ensuring prosperous beginnings for the nation. However, even lawmakers have expressed their dissatisfaction on the parliament's performance and have admitted that the parliament has failed to live up to public's expectations. The first session of the House of Representatives was held on 5th of March 2018. The first round of sessions largely focused on laws relating to fundamental rights. However, parliamentary proceedings were affected due to COVID-19 pandemic in 2020 on top of internal issues within the then ruling alliance parties CPN-UML and CPN-Maoist Centre. The government led by parties of the left attempted to dissolve the parliament first on 20th of December 2020 and then on 21st of May 2021. However, the Supreme Court reinstated the parliament on both the occasions. CPN-UML continued to obstruct the parliament as it played the role of main opposition following the formation of a government of the alliance between 5 parties, including Nepali Congress and Maoist Centre. Likewise, apart from the endorsement of a few amendment bills like the citizenship bill, the 5-party alliance itself could not ensure smooth functioning of the parliament. The government was also mired in controversy surrounding the MCC program and strategic partnership program, to name a few. Lawmakers from the ruling coalition itself say that the parliament in its 5 years has failed to deliver on its promises to the people. Analysts meanwhile add that the parliament failed to perform due to internal and external political bickerings. In the face of the lack of cooperation from suspended Chief Justice Cholinder Shamsher Rana, the Parliament's Impeachment Recommendation Committee could not end the process of clarification authentication yesterday. The committee had earlier planned to authenticate the clarification process, submit the report yesterday itself, and present it for a decision at the Parliament today. The meeting yesterday turned heated as suspended Chief Justice Rana, who had received the clarification for authentication a week ago, however, cited time constraint, delaying the entire process. Rana initially tried to authenticate his clarification on all the 43 questions on a whole. However, it was later rejected as the authentication process eventually got delayed. Out of the 174-page long clarification, only 65 pages have been authenticated. Considering that the term of the House of Representatives is coming to an end from midnight tonight, the Impeachment Recommendation Committee wants to finish with the procedures of the authentication as soon as possible today. However, the members of the committee with the leaning to the main opposition, CPN-UML, have been trying to delay the process. It is understandable that they want to delay the process so that the entire impeachment motion becomes meaningless after the expiry of the term of the lower house from midnight tonight. It might look surprising that the Kathmandu metropolis has begun a campaign and succeeded to an extent in finding a lost rivulet of Kathmandu. The metropolis, in its latest campaign for heritage conservation, has begun searching for the lost Tukucha, which in Nepal Bhasa or the Newari dialect is also known as Tukucha and Ichumati in Sanskrit language. The metropolis has dismantled a few structures built over the rivulet, while a dozen more excavations are expected to take place in search for the Tukucha watercourse in the coming days.
The Tukucha watercourse that is believed to originate from Dumbarai area of Ring Road in Kathmandu meets the Bagmati River in Thapathali's Kalmochan. The 5-kilometer-long rivulet runs through Lajimpat and Balwatar, among other places where concrete structures and blacktop roads have been built. In the 420-meter-long distance between the capital's popular cinema hall, Jainapal, and Kathmandu Plaza, dozens of high-rise commercial buildings and other structures have been built over the rivulet. Tukucha's existence can, however, still be seen despite roads being built along the Dumbarai region, Tudal, Devi, Balwatar, Lajimpat, Northgate, Garidhara, and the Republic Memorial Park. The Kathmandu metropolis 13 years ago had initiated a campaign to uncover the long-lost river. The metropolis tried to revive the campaign 3 years ago, however, works were limited to formality both the times. Parts of the rivulet came to light recently as the metropolis dismantled few structures between Kathmandu Plaza and Jainapal Theatre as part of Kathmandu Mayor Balin Sar's campaign to remove unauthorized structures from the capital. Even as the metropolis plans to continue its pursuit of the lost rivulet, it is bound to face plenty of challenges along. The metropolis also faces a challenge in uncovering many of the rivulets in Tilganga, Samakhusi, and Baneswar, to name a few inlets that have been lost in the face of massive urbanization of Kathmandu Valley.
In an unfortunate development, we have received news of massive landslide in the western district of Achham. It is reported that some 4 people have been killed while 19 others are missing. Likewise, in Kainali, some 600 households have been reported flooded as water-related disasters continue to wreak havoc in the western parts of the country. Now, in our Public Voice segment, today we've asked people in several provinces what should be done to raise women's participation in decision-making roles. Let's take a look at what they had to say.
बोलीमा भन्दा पनि व्यवहारमा चाहिँ महिलाहरुलाई चाहिँ सम्मान गरेर चाहिँ
पुरुष र महिला भनेर भेदभाव हुनु भएन
महिलाहरु शिक्षित हुनु पर्छ आफ्नो हक अधिकार आफैले उनीहरुले लिनु पर्यो
33% देखि नभएर 50% सम्म पुर्यायो भने निर्णायक तहमा चाहिँ नि उनीहरु पुग्न सक्छ
पारिवारिक सपोर्ट राम्रो हुनु पर्यो
अधिकार लिनको लागि चाहिँ महिलाहरु पछाडि हट्नु भएन
बेसी नीतिलाई सही ढंगले कार्यान्वयन गर्नुपर्छ
महिलाहरुलाई चाहिँ अवसरको आवश्यकता देखिन्छ
Text us with your opinion. The question is, what do you think of the latest initiatives by Kathmandu Metropolis in heritage conservation? Your options are A, responsibility of people's representatives, B, respecting public sentiments, and C, challenging the federal government. The voting is on. Type NEWS, select your option A, B, or C, and send it to 34001 to share your opinion with us. Nepal crushed 5-times champions India 1-0 in the semi-finals of the SAAF Women's Championship to register a historic victory on their way to the tournament finals. In the match played at Dashrath Stadium under floodlights, home team Nepal, spurred on by a partisan crowd, put up a commendable performance. Nepal dominated the first 15 minutes while got the all-important lead at the stroke of half-time. The goal scorer was Rashmi Kissing, who was well-fed with a pass by Preeti Rai, who was later adjudged player of the match. The goal proved decisive as Nepal held on to the one-goal advantage to advance into the finals. This would be the first India-less final in the history of SAAF Women's Championship as Nepal take on Bangladesh in the finals on Monday.